Hello everyone, this is Shankar from 4Kites. So I am here with my team, Nitin, Yamini and Hari. So I'm here to talk about the developer portal that we have developed recently and launched in production. And it's all about 4Kites developer portal, the journey about like the developer portal that we have developed in in-house. So let me talk about a little bit about developer portal. So as everyone knows, like developer portal is a page or it's a place where the API producers like showcase their APIs, and the consumers can easily start consuming their API by reading through the documentation and like by picking the one that they need to integrate. So it is typically between the interface among the API producer and the API consumer. So, and obviously we need a developer portal like in order to automate and reduce the time taken for the customer integrations, and it will give the more confident and better customer experience for our customers, and it will also reduce the cost that involved like going front and back and having meetings with the customers to make the API integration. So we all know that, and I just quickly move on to the evaluation criteria that we have done. So in the initial phase, we were like evaluating multiple API products, the developer portal products that are available in the market, which includes nearly 7 to 8 products. And the evaluation criteria were mainly based on the needs that the organization wants. Say in terms of 4Kites, so we wanted to have a like a main features that we listed in the document here. So it should be open source so that like in future, if you want to make any modification in the existing developer portal, we should be allowed. So that was one of the primary criteria, and it should be self-hosted where our data will not go out of our control. And the custom authentication and custom authorization. So those were the main piece, like we were not making this to public. So we wanted to keep the developer portal in the private and the internal zone. So those who are our customers, the 4Kites customers, so we are giving APIs to them. So those are like paid customers. They can alone access our API developer portal instead of like making it public. So we want to impose an authentication as well as the authorization flow. And that should be possible in the developer portal. So that also taken into consideration, and the language support that the developer portal provides. So the like highlighting the languages that we have quoted in the developer portal, it includes the most famous languages that our customers use, include Java, Ruby, Go, curl command. So all those stuff. So it should have a like a variety of language support so that like we can pick whatever our customers use, and we can make it easy for them to copy paste the code that we provide in the developer portal. And the UI customer session, like which will be very crucial point for like the customers to make them more delightful when they go through the developer portal. And that should be possible with the developer portal that we are going to pick it up. And the content making the developer portal should be easy, like by just importing the API spec, like Swagger spec or Open API spec. So for the internal team, that will be even more easy for them to make the content populated in the developer portal. And obviously like the pricing will play an important role. So whether it's an open source developer portal that we're going to choose, or it's an enterprise one. So the pricing plays all over the important role again. So based on these criteria, we have selected, like we have evaluated nearly 7 developer portals, and we have come up with the one that suits 4Kites. Like, as I said, like, so we are going to launch the developer portal. So it shouldn't be complete even without making it more self-serviceable. So what we have thought is we just created a self-service portal wherein our internal customers or our 4Kites customers go and like they can generate the authentication credential that is required by the APIs that is being exposed to the developer portal. So we created a self-service portal wherein our customers will go on, and so this is how like the authentication will work for the self-service portal. So once they log in, we list down the APIs which are available through the developer portal, and we allow them to create the API key which will be used to for them to authenticate those APIs. So the basic concept here is like we create bundles, like you can say the subscription. So we have different bundles, like since we are in supply chain management, so the ultimate goal is like we allow the customers to create the loads and allow them to track the loads. So in order to create the loads and update and track the loads, so we have like a bunch of APIs. So those will be clubbed under the load visibility package. And this is the like marketing page where we publish the developer portal API bundles for the customers, so that like when someone wants to give a try, so they can look at the bundles that we provide, so that they get more confidence on like how the integration system will work for them in future if they make a sign in. And we do have some best practices that we expect, like that we followed, and we expect the other teams also to follow while developing the developer portal. So they are pretty much same like how we have evaluated earlier. So the popular language support is the first one, and the self-service portal, so making it more self-service or more automated will make the customer integration even easier. So, and we do have a restriction on few places, like the API key creation should be of maximum of 2, which makes like more robustness, and which will restrict the use of the API keys per customer. And we do have a rotation policy based on the month or expiration. And grouping the APIs and accessing them using the features or the license that we provide. Say suppose in forecast, like we have a number of customers, and some customers will have different licenses or feature access, and some will have different things. So we won't show all the bundles that we expose through the developer portal. We show the relevant bundles to the licensed folks. And the build structure standards and the structure of the APIs. So across the forecast, we want to follow the standards. So those will be exposed through the developer portal. That will be documented clearly at the front. And that includes like rate limiting, request size, request format, response format, what the different HTTP response format that we provide, and what is the reason for that. And I mean, having a common authentication. So what all the authentication will be supported. So all those 4K standards will be published, and that will make more confident on the customer side. Like they can read through that, and then they can easily make integration with them. And the final plan is like to make a monetization plan. So based on the traffic and based on the need from the customers, so those customers who want to access our APIs more frequently for the data, and those we can in future, we can plan for them for the monetization purpose. Say we can create different plans, and based on the customer access to the APIs, we can provide a detailed like plan and the price for each access. So that is pretty much about the overall journey. So let me quickly go through the actual developer portal and give you a demo to us. So this is the developer portal dev version. So this is the landing page where we have the versions control, like what are the versions we have released, and in this version, so what are the updates that we have released as part of the latest version. And here we have like a documentation page link, which will actually go allow you to log into the developer portal documentation page. And before going to the developer portal, I just want to give a quick overview of the self-service portal. So in the self-service portal, since I logged in as an admin, I just want to select a company. So once I select a company, like is a customer. So once I move into the API management tab, here you are allowed to create API keys. So once I click on generate an API key, so I just want to give some basic credentials. And the API key will be generated, and I have to choose the list of packages that the API key wants to access. So we'll be having different packages. So we can choose that, and we can create a new API key using that package. So this API key, whichever I created, will have access to those API bundles. And the list of APIs available in the bundles will be shown here. If you click on the bundle name, you will be showing like the list of API keys available. Let me jump on to the documentation. So this is the developer portal where we have a static documentation. And here, if you see the list of standard that the 4K wants to impose to the customers. So like in the introduction and then the few other pages, we will be deeply talking about the authentication and then the pagination, and then the date and time format that we want to follow across the 4K APIs. And basically the versioning of different documentations and the rate limiting that we already have in the APIs that we expose. And as well as we have the response interpretation, where like what are the different responses that we expect from each of the APIs, and what are the different meanings of those API responses. And if you go to the next section, which is called API bundles, where we list down the list of bundles that we currently provide. So we currently provide 5 bundles, and inside each bundle, so what are the APIs that we expose. So creating the load, updating it, deleting it, and all those basic operations, and making a few other APIs available in that bundle. And the full documentation and the will be available in the center medium with the request and response format. And in the right hand side, if you see, like, we support nearly seven different languages. And here we have a simple code snippet, which they can copy and start accessing our APIs. They just want to replace the API key that we that they can produce themselves in this self-service page. So once they replace the key, they can start using our APIs, consuming our APIs, using the code snippet that we provide it based on their integration system. And the future plan is, like, we want to create a monetization so that, like, the more frequent accessing customers will get charged. So in that way, like, it will become a profitable model in future as well. So that is the overall demo of the developer portal from FourKage. So thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
So hello, welcome to the stage. We have here Hari, Shankar, and Yamini also, and Nitin. And you are the team who built and created, dreamed, and maintains this portal. But this is not a Rome that was built in a day. Which teams were involved, and what aspects did they take on to create this platform? And you're still working on it.
I'll take the lead on this question. So I belong to the product team at FourKage, and Nitin, Shankar, and Yamini are from the engineering team. They predominantly handle all the technical aspects on this. So in terms of the teams that got involved overall, it was more of a company-wide initiative where we wanted to streamline the ways we were exposing the APIs, and we wanted to make sure that it all goes through the same pipeline. So we had a pretty significant involvement from the executive team to start with, and we had a couple of product managers ensuring that we strive through the requirements, understand the whole things, and we had the whole systems engineering along with the tech ops and DevOps team making sure that we have all the InfoSec compliance and security stuff in place, in addition to all the existing capabilities that we have in terms of the API. And in terms of external teams, we also had pretty good involvement from the UX team to help out build out the API management piece, so we are able to cater to companies that are pretty small, that are shipping 10,000 shipments a year, to Fortune 100 companies that are managing millions of shipments across the globe. We also had a marketing team that helped us build out a pretty neat homepage on the FourKage corporate website, so that would also help us generate more leads into the developer portal as well as to the whole platform. We had involvement from CareerOps team. What we call as carriers are basically our partners who help us share data for our customers, and also our customer success team. So the developer portal basically housed APIs that are already in production for a lot of our existing customers. So we also had a significant involvement from our operations and customer success team to ensure that we are migrating them as cleanly as possible without breaking any kind of integration. So they move from the old non-streamlined API endpoints to this new developer portal, which is much more centrally managed environment. Mm-hmm. So and we also have a pretty significant involvement from our knowledge base team, or the content management team, and we also the engineering team also had them trained through the whole Slate documentation and all of these technical aspects. So they're kind of on their own autopilot to ensure that whenever any endpoint or a payload gets updated, they're able to manage without any handholding from our engineering team. Mm-hmm.
And in hindsight, so you were migrating customers while they were active. Is there some kind of documentation that you realized while doing this migration that it was absolutely necessary to inform people? Like, you didn't expect that because you thought the technicals would be enough, but there was something that was really necessary for people to start smoothly using the portal.
So, I mean, before we actually started going live, when, as we were in the final stages of development, we already had informed our customers that there is a change that was expected. Mm-hmm. And this was also, we also informed the customer that this is not going to be a binary cut over where we will switch off the older integrations on one day and they'll will force them to use a newer integration. So there are some customers who have a dedicated IT team with respect to the 4KH integration. So they are able to react faster to any changes that we make on our platform. There are also some teams, some companies or customers who are not that technologically advanced in terms of how quickly they can turn around any updates on the integration. So we had them informed that this is coming, but nobody is surprised that there is a change. And we also ensured that we carry the migration for all the customers at their own pace, not necessarily forcing them to use the newer portal. Mm-hmm. So it's been a couple of quarters since the developer portal has launched, and we have migrated almost 90% of our customers. There are still a couple of the long tail, low volume customer that we're still doing the migration for. Mm-hmm.
Just one point I wanted to add there is our implementation team as well stated that our customers are now finding it relatively easy because every piece of information is available in a single portal, right? So it's like kind of a really streamlined for them is what we learned. But of course, yes, we can iterate more. Just wanted to add that.
Mm-hmm. Among the questions, there are some very technical questions about what platform you use. Did you build that yourself? Do you use Markdown? We are very short on time, so I asked that if you could write those technical answers in the chat for people. And there was also the question, how does this help with self-onboarding that everything is hidden behind a login? And in the beginning, Sankar was saying in the presentation that it's very much on purpose that everything is hidden behind the login.
It was more of a strategic decision that we didn't want to expose the documentation to anybody on the internet because the real-time visibility is kind of a growing market and we have a lot of new players that are coming in every year. And we want to ensure that we just don't give away the way we work with our customers, all the payloads, the transactions that happen with our customers, just for anybody else to see. So we kind of have it available once you have a login, and this is available basically for any customer who's already a 4KH, any user who's a 4KH customer, or if they are doing a pilot with 4KH. Mm-hmm. So it's available if you are a partner for 4KH or if you are working with 4KH in some sense, but we just don't, it was a strategic decision that we don't want to expose the API documentation directly on the internet, at least for a couple of years. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much.